So today in this session, we will be discussing about two major topics. One topic is your sets, which is a very basic topic. You have studied this topic in your college time, and even in your school time, you have studied the same topic. So the set topic will be kind of a revision for everyone, because this is the basic concept of sets. What is set? What is a subset? What is the cardinality of set? We are going to discuss all these basic things. And then when we finished the concept of sets, we will start the concepts of relations. Now the concepts of relations is very important, because even the concept of lattice is also based on the concept of relations, and the concept of relations is based on the concepts of sets. So we will be starting with the concept of set, and then we will be covering the concept of relations, and from relations we'll be covering the concepts of lattices. Okay, I hope all of you are ready for the session, because I think I've started the streaming at 7:24, so we can start at 7:30. That will be convenient for everyone, I guess. So before 7:30, we can take up some of your questions, or if there's anything you want to talk about. We have 6 minutes before we start. Yes, we will have live classes for paper one also. So this time, see, last time a few subjects that were done by Naveen sir in the last session, I'm going to take those subjects in this session, and he's going to take some different subjects. Okay, so what we are planning is every subject should be taught by multiple faculties. So some of the students here who have taken the subscription for the last year, for example, Garima is there, Darpan is there. So the subjects which were taught by Naveen sir, now in this session most of those subjects are, I'm going to teach most of those subjects, and some of the subjects which I had taught last session, so some of those subjects will be taught by Naveen sir. Okay, as well as we will also have classes for paper 1. So paper 1 classes will also be there. So obviously that is a good news for everyone, even for the old students as well as new students. Obviously we'll have classes for paper 1, and what we are planning is on weekends we'll have paper 1 classes. For example, maybe on Saturday, Sundays we will have paper 1 classes for the next 6 months. Okay, paper 1, Naveen sir is going to take paper 1 right now. Okay, yes Pallavi, what is the problem? Yes Harika, PDF of the previous sir question, that is ready, but there's some spelling mistakes that Rana sir is working on. So by tomorrow definitely you will get the PDF of the previous sir questions. Okay, any other question? So in today's PPT Pallavi, or yesterday's PPT? We are planning paper 1 classes on weekends. So mostly on weekends paper 1 classes will be there. Sure, maybe what we'll do is, Pallavi, after today's session, in the end, we will take the doubts from the previous session. So, whatever your doubts was, for example, you had some doubt on page number 20 of the PPT. So, we will take those doubts after today's session, okay? Samita, we shared the PPT on the Telegram group. If you are not on the Telegram group, please ask Abhilasha ma'am to add you on the Telegram group, so that we can, you can get all the updated material from the Telegram group. And those students who have not joined the Telegram group from the previous session also, please join the Telegram group as soon as possible, because it is easier to share files on the Telegram group, and there are some good features in Telegram group which are good, okay? So should we start? Okay, 2 minutes. It's 7:28, so we'll start by 7:30. So first of all, for the first half an hour, we will be discussing the basics of this sets. Yes, Garima, we are deleting the WhatsApp group because there are a lot of issues with the WhatsApp group. There's no meaning of WhatsApp group then, right? So this is WhatsApp group. I'm just not deleting so that everyone will get updated. As soon as everyone joins Telegram group, I'll delete the WhatsApp group. Test series is already, this year we have not changed any question on the test series. the same last year test series will be published this year. So if you want to take the test series, obviously right now you can discuss with ma'am. So I mean test series will be the same. So there's no difference in last year's test series as well as this year's test series. I'm good, Sakshi, how are you? We are not working on new test series this year because from last 3 years we were working on the test series. So what we have done is we have compiled the question, we have increased the number of tests to 50. And now this year also the same test series will be there, okay? Because a lot of effort to work on test series, as well as the number of students in NIELIT are very less comparatively, okay? Chalo, let us start. So before we start, I want all of you to answer what is sets. What do you mean by sets? What are sets? Please write in the chat window what are sets. Yes, Garima, paper 1 classes will be on weekends. Naveen sir suggested me, I told him that we can have paper 1 classes in the end after completing the entire syllabus. But then Naveen sir said it is better if we take paper 1 classes on weekends or maybe on Sundays. Okay. So all of you please answer, what are set? What do you mean by set? Sakshi, maybe let us answer these questions after this class now. Okay. So as you can see, a set is an unordered collection of objects called elements and members of the set or members of the set. A set is said to contain its element. We write A belongs to the set A, where A is the element and this is the name of the set, to denote that A is an element of the set A. The notation A, and this notation says does not belong to A, that means A is not an element of the set A. So here there are few important things. For example, a few people said here that it is the group of similar things. Set is not a group of similar things. For example, here Madhuri said group of similar elements, Mary said group of similar elements. So even Dev said collection of identical elements, collection of distinct objects. So basically set is not a group of similar element. When you talk about arrays, arrays are group of similar kind of, you know, data. For example, you have integers, right? You can have arrays of integers, you can have array of floating point number, you can have arrays of character, you can have array of strings. But when we discuss about set, set is a collection, unordered collection of distinct element. Doesn't matter whether they are of same type or not. For example, I can say we can have a set which is containing the elements, which is 4, Ram, Sita, and we have maybe some symbol. So we can have a set where these elements are, all these elements are different. But the only thing is these elements should not be repeated elements. All of these elements should be distinct elements. These should be distinct objects. So distinct element means a set cannot contain two elements which are same. For example, in a set we cannot have 4, 4, 1, 2, 3, 3. So here two elements are same. For example, 4 and 4, these both of these 4 are same, 3 and 3, these are repetitive elements. So sets does not contain repetitive elements. Set always contain the elements which are distinct, or you can say unique elements, or you can say here this set is actually equivalent to saying, it is equivalent to saying set which is having 1, 2, 3 and 4. Because even if we have number 3 two times, doesn't mean, because in a set this element will be counted only once. So set cannot have duplicate elements. So this is a very simple definition of a set. Now there are various ways of representation of a set. How do you represent a set? So one of the representation is given on your screen. So as you can see here, we can have a set V of vowels in English where all the elements are mentioned. So elements are A, E, I, O, U. And here the set of O of odd positive integers less than 10, that can be expressed by O is equal to 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So basically, we can have various representations of the set. The first representation is your roster method. Roster method means we are going to mention all the elements that are present inside the set here. For example, the elements here are A, E, I, O, U. here the elements are 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So if we are going to mention all these elements in the set explicitly, that is called as the roster method. So this is one of the way of representing the elements of a set. Just read this paragraph once. Take your time and read the first paragraph once. Just read this paragraph once. So it contains the definition of a set. So you can see there are several ways of describing a set. One way is to list all the element, all the members of the set when this is possible. And this kind of notation is called as your roster method. So second notation here is your set builder method. So set builder method is something where you are going to define some kind of properties so that we can build the set, we can define, we can tell what are the elements that should be present inside the set. For example, here you can see we have a set O is equal to X such that X is an odd positive integer which is less than 10. So specifically, explicitly, I am not telling what are the elements that are present inside the set, but rather I am giving you some kind of property. Using this property, you can tell what are the elements. In the same way, I can also represent it like this. The set O is X belongs to Z positive. Here the Z positive is representing positive integer numbers. So this is a universal notation representation, shortcut representation of positive integers, or you can say for integers we use Z, where such that X is an odd number as well as X is less than 10. So this kind of representation is called as a set builder form. So just read this paragraph once and you will understand what is a set builder form. So very simple definition of set. So basically, just like we have used this definition of integers, which is set builder form, the definition Z for positive integers, in the same way we use various notations to represent different kind of sets. For example, we use capital N to represent the set of natural numbers. We use capital Z to represent the set of integers. It contains both the positive integers as well as the negative integers. We use Z positive to represent the set of positive integers. And here you can see in positive integers we are not writing 0. We use Q to represent the set of rational numbers. So rational numbers are the numbers which are in the form of P by Q. So P by Q, where P is an integer as well as Q is an integer, and Q cannot be 0. Here P can be 0 but Q cannot be 0. So if you want to represent the set of rational numbers, for that we use Q. If you want to represent the set of real numbers, for that we use R. If you want to represent the set of positive real numbers, for that we use R plus. And if you want to represent the set of complex number, for that we use C. So in this same way you can represent sets here. So these notations actually you should remember, because these notations are going to be very useful for you while solving your questions. If you do not know these notations, then you will not be able to solve questions, and some of the times you will not be able to understand the questions properly. So do one thing, take your time and write these notations in your notebook, because all these notations are very, very important. Just write these notations, because after writing you will be able to remember more easily. As soon as you have done it, as soon as you have written, just comment done on the chat window. Yes, natural numbers does not contain zero. So just check out something that I've sent on your chat window. So next here is intervals. So as you can see here, what are intervals? Let me turn on the light, I guess. Better. Good. So intervals, as you can see, we use two notations to represent intervals. If we write an angular bracket like this, angular bracket means it is a closed interval. If we write this brackets like this, circular brackets, it means open interval. Now what do you mean by closed interval and open interval? The first says, for example, if I say we have an angular bracket 1, 3, so that means this set will contain the values which is 1, 2, and 3. Here closed interval means this 1 and 3, they are included. Okay, so if I say, write it like this, 1, 3, and this is open interval. So open interval means this 3 is not included, so this is actually equivalent to 1, 2 only. So this is representing the example of open interval. So if I write it like this, it means it is containing the values which is 2, 3. And if I write like this, 1, 2 in brackets, so this is actually equivalent to saying, so 1, 3 in brackets, so this is actually equivalent to saying it is having only one value, which is 2. So this is the closed interval, and these brackets are representing the open interval. In case of open interval, these values, for example, A and B, they are not included. But in case of closed interval, these A and B, they are included. I feel that all of you already know this. So this is just for revision purposes, you can use it. What are intervals? What is a closed interval? And what is a open interval? Okay. Next, when do you say the two sets are equal? So two sets are equal if and only if they have the same element. So if there's any element, so as you can see this definition, therefore if A and B are sets, then A and B are equal if and only if. So you can see here they have to use the word if and only if. For all x, x belongs to A, by implication x also belongs to B. That if, it means if the element x is in the set A, then element x should also be in the set B. This is implied. Okay, if two sets are equal, then we write A equals B. Okay, so here if the sets are equal, the order of the elements does not matter. For example, here in this set the elements 1, 3, 5, and here in this set we have the elements 3, 5, 1. So both of these sets are equal because they are having exactly the same elements. Does not matter what is the order of these elements. Okay, so you should know what are sets which are equal. Second is your empty set and singleton sets. So empty set is a set which is not having any values or any elements. For example, we represent empty sets by this empty brackets, or we represent the empty set by 5. So either you can represent empty set by these brackets, or you can represent empty set by 5. But if you have a set like this, if you represent something like this, it means it is a set which is containing one element, and this one element is an empty set. Okay, so this is actually equivalent to saying opening bracket like this. Okay, so this is not an empty set, as well as this is not an empty set. So empty set is the set which is not having any element, which can be represented by these brackets, or it can be represented by 5. And here in this case, in these brackets we have 5, so that means in this set we have one element which is 5, and one element is this empty set. So this is a set which is containing an empty set. So this is a set which is containing an empty set. So you should be clear that if you do representations like this, so this is not representing an empty set. Okay, so first of all, you should know what is an empty set. So empty set is a set which is not having any values. Empty set is also called as null set, and it is denoted by 5. And if you have a singleton set is a set which is having only one value. For example, if I have the set A which is having only one value, which is 1, so this is now representing a singleton set. So you can clearly see a singleton set is only having one value, but an empty set cannot have any value. So an empty set is represented by 5, or it is represented by these brackets like this. Okay, I hope you don't have any doubts in this. If you have any doubt, please ask as soon as you get a doubt. Next is the definition of a subset. So what is a subset? A set A is the subset of a set B if and only if every element of B is also an element of A, then we say that B is a subset of A. Again, I'm repeating, if every element of the set B is also the element of the set A, then we say that B is a subset of A. For example, if we have a set A which is having the values 1, 2, 3, 4, if we have a set B which is having the values 1, 3, so every element of set B is also an element of set A, therefore we can say B is a subset of A. If I take a set C which is having the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, now these 4 elements of set C is also an element of A, but here this 5 is not an element of A. So we cannot say that C is not a subset of A. So I mean, we can say C is not a subset of A, but here you can clearly see A is a subset of C. Now we can also have a set D here, assuming the set D is having the values which are 1, 2, 3 and 4. So I can say every element of set D is also an element of set A, and every element of set A is also an element of set D. So here you can say A is a subset of set D, as well as D is also a subset of set A. If this kind of condition occurs, that means A is equal to D. So if two sets are equal, then they are subsets of each other. So every set is a subset of itself, which is a trivial thing. Okay. By the way, how many of you can define what do you mean by trivial? What do you mean by trivial? Can you define trivial? Trivial. Just write in the chat window, what do you mean by trivial? No, trivial is does not mean unique. Trivial does not mean equal in element. See, there are few words that most of you people do not understand even while reading your books. Most of you must have heard the word which is explicit. You must have heard the word which is implicit. You must have heard the word which is trivial. So these words are very repeatedly used in your textbooks, and you just read the definition without understanding the meaning of explicit, without understanding the meaning of implicit, without understanding the meaning of trivial. These kind of words are very important. Okay, so just do some research on trivial, and what do you mean by trivial, you just try to explain me. Okay, so by the way, every set is also a subset of itself, which is trivial. So you can understand this thing later on. So here you can see there's a definition, that is quantification definition for subsets, which is when we say A is a subset of B, it means for all X, if X is a subset, X belongs to the set A, implies X also belongs to the set B. So this is how you can quantify this thing. Okay. So if you want to show that it is not a subset, if you want to show that A is not a subset of B, then we can show, if we can find at least one element which is present in A, but that element is not present in B, then we say A is not a subset of B. For example, here in this set, we have one element which is 5. And this 5 is not a subset, is not us in the set A. So we can say C is not a subset of A. It's very easy, okay? These things you already know. These are very basic concepts of sets. So I'm covering these concepts so that we can have some kind of revision, okay? So just for revision purposes, I'm covering these concepts. At least we should complete every topic. Okay. So this is to show that A is a subset of B, then we have to show that every element of A is also an element of B. And to show that A is not a subset of B, then we show that at least if we can find one single element which is present in A but not in B, then we say that A is not a subset of B. So here you can see for every set, phi is a subset as well as that set itself is a subset. Okay, but what do I mean by this is, if you take any random set in the world, any set, set of any element, set of any alphabet, set of any numbers or anything, for example, we have a set of A, E, 1, 2. So this is a set. For any set in the world, there are two sets which are always there. For example, phi is always a subset of A, as well as these elements, for example A is always a subset of itself. So these two things are very trivial, or you can say they are very basic thing, that every set is having two subsets, which is phi as well as A. Okay, now next is the definition of proper subsets. What do you mean by proper subset? So proper subset is basically a subset which does not contain the equal values. Okay. So here you can see, just read the definition. When we wish to emphasize that a set A is a subset of set B, but that A is not equal to B, we write A is a proper subset of B. And say that A is a proper subset of B, for all A is a proper subset of B to be true, it must be the case that A is a subset of B, and there must exist an element X of B that is not an element of A. That is, A is a proper subset of B if and only if this condition follows. What do I mean to say by this? What do I mean to say by this definition? If I say we have a set A, and this set A is having the values 1, 2, 3, 5, and 7. These are the values which are present in the set A. And if I say we have a set B which is having the values 1, 3, 5, and 7. Now you can clearly see that B is a subset of A, as well as B is also a proper subset of A. The first here it says B is a subset of A. The second notation says B is a proper subset of A. So B is a proper subset of A. This can only be true when B is not having at least one element which is present in A. Or you can say that if B is equal to A, then B cannot be a proper subset. Okay, let me explain you more easily. Let me explain this to you in Hindi in more proper way. देखो जब भी हम लोग proper subset की बात करते हैं, proper subset means कि जो दूसरा सेट है वो इसका सबसेट तो होना ही होना चाहिए, लेकिन इक्वल वैल्यूज़ नहीं आनी चाहिए. जैसे कि यहाँ पर B के अंदर B जो है A का सबसेट है, और B के अंदर A के इक्वल वैल्यूज़ नहीं है. दैट इज़ वाई वी कैन से B इज़ अ प्रॉपर सबसेट ऑफ A. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ़ आई टेक अ सेट C विच इज़ हैविंग द वैल्यूज 1, 2, 3, 5 and 7. नाउ यू कैन अगेन क्लियरली सी दैट दिस सेट C इज़ अ सबसेट ऑफ सेट A. सेट C इज़ अ सबसेट ऑफ सेट A. But C is not a proper subset of set A. Why C is not a proper subset? Because the values in C are equal to the values of the set A. So in a proper subset, we cannot have equal values. So you should know the definition of proper subset. Okay? Any doubts in this whatsoever? Do you guys have any doubt? My dear friends, do you have any doubt? If you have any doubts whatsoever, please write on the chat window so that I can answer your doubts. Right, these are very easy and basic things, right? Good. Any other students who are having doubts, all of you please reply in the chat window quickly so that we can proceed quickly. आपके रिप्लाईज मुझे जल्दी आते रहेंगे तो मुझे क्लियरिटी रहेगी कि आपको समझ में आ रहा है या नहीं आ रहा. सी, मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम व्हाट हैपेंस इज ड्यूरिंग अ क्लासरूम वी कैन सी अ स्टूडेंट, आई कैन सी यू क्लियरली दैट हाउ यू आर सिटिंग, व्हाट आर योर रिएक्शंस, व्हाट आर योर एक्सप्रेशंस, एंड अकॉर्डिंगली आई कैन फिगर आउट दैट यू आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड मी और नॉट, और यू आर एबल टू फॉलो मी और नॉट. बट ड्यूरिंग अ लाइव सेशंस आई कैन नॉट सी यू, आई कैन ओनली अंडरस्टैंड योर एक्सप्रेशन बाय योर चैट. सो timely, it's better to reply in the chat quickly so that I'll be able to figure out that you are able to understand or not. Okay, but I feel these topics are also easy, but still if you have any doubt whatsoever at any point of time, please let me know. I'll be very happy to reply. Okay, so as you can see, this is the equal set. Again, this is again definition. If we say two set A and B, if I say A is a subset of B as well as B is also a subset of A, then we say the set A and B are equal. Okay. Next is, a set may have other sets as a member. For example, here you can clearly see the set A is a set of sets. So it is having the first set which is 5, the second set which is containing a single element A, the third set which is containing a single element B, as well as a fourth set which is containing two sets, which is containing two elements. So you can clearly see it is not necessary that a set is only having elements. A set may only having elements which are not set. A set may have elements which are itself sets. So set may be containing sets. Okay. So you should know this definition. Next is about finite set. So finite sets are the sets which are containing finite elements. If a set is having finite elements, that set will be called as a finite set. Finite elements means which you can count. Okay, that's very easy. And secondly, we have something called as cardinality. So cardinality of the set is what are the number of elements that are present inside the set. For example, if I say we have a set A which is having the elements A, E, I, O, and U. This is a set A. So if I say what is the cardinality of set A, cardinality of set A will be 5. Okay. In the same way, we can have a set and there will be cardinality of a set. We can have a set and if we count the number of elements, that will be called as cardinality of the set. For example, let A be the set of odd positive integers which are less than 10. So how many positive integers are there which are less than 10? Which are, these integers are 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. So these are odd positive integers which are less than 10. If I see the cardinality of this set, so how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there are 5 elements in this set, that is why cardinality of this set is 5. No, proper sets and posets are not same. Poset is partially ordered set. So when you say proper set, it is not equal to poset. So we'll be having partially ordered set. Okay, so we'll be seeing that partially ordered set later on. Because after, before lattice, we have to understand the posets, partially ordered set. Okay. Next is the definition of infinite set. That is a set which is containing infinite number of elements. That is called as an infinite set. Now this is important. So most of the students have issues with this, and this is called as a power set. So what do you mean by power set? Power set is the set of subsets of a set. Okay, so power set is set of all the subsets of a given set. So let me show you with the help of an example. If we have a set A and it is having the values 0, 1 and 2. It is having 3 values. So how many subset of set A is there? We can have a set which is 5 or empty set. This is a subset of the set A. We can have a set which is having only one element. So this is a subset of A. So it's again having only one element, it's a subset of A. Again, this is having only one element. Again, this is a subset of A. We can also have a set which are having two elements. For example, here this set is containing two elements, which is 1, 2. It is a subset of A. We can have a set which is having an element, which is 0, 2, which is also a subset of A. We can have a set which is having the elements 0, 1. It is also a subset of A. As well as we can have a set which is having the element 0, 1 and 2. It is also a subset of A. So you can see how many subsets of A are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there are 8 subsets of the set. So if you create a set which is containing all these subsets, that will be called as a power set of A. So if I say what is a power set of A? So power set of A is a set of all subsets. So for example, the first subset is 5. The second subset is having value 0, 1 and 2. The third subset is having the values which is 1, 2, 0, 2, 0, 1. The fourth here will be 0, 1 and 2. So this is the set which is containing all the subsets of A, that is called as a power set. Any doubts in power set? So is there any doubts in power set whatsoever, my dear friends? Good. You guys are very smart, super intelligent, amazing, extraordinary. Chalo. So how many elements will be there in the power set? So you can see power set, what are the number of elements? There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So in the power set of A, there are total of 8 elements. And how do you find it? So basically, for every element of A, we have two choices, whether this will be in the subset or not. So it is having two choices. Whether this element 1 will be in the subset or not, so it is having two choices. Whether this element 2 will be in the subset or not, it is having two choices. So if you multiply this 2 by 2 with 2, this is going to be 2 raised to power 3, or you can say total 8. So you can clearly see this set is having 8 subsets. So that is why we say if the cardinality of a set A is n, then number of subsets of A is going to be 2 raised to power n, and number of elements in power set of A is going to be 2 raised to power n, or you can say the cardinality of power set of A is going to be 2 raised to power n. So these elements will be there in the power set of the set A. Clear? My dear friends, any doubts? I don't think so you have any doubts. You guys are very smart, intelligent, super intelligent people. Next is power set of an empty set. So if we have an empty set, let us suppose we have a set A which is phi, or you can say the set A is like this. So it means it is an empty set. So the power set of an empty set contains only one element, which is that empty set itself. So because you already know that the number of elements will be here, the cardinality of A is 0, so cardinality of power set of A is going to be 2 raised to power 0, which is equal to 1. So if a set is not having any elements, or if a set is having cardinality as 0, so its power set will be having cardinality as 1. So power set of an empty set is going to be having cardinality as 1. Now if I say we have the power set of the power set of a set which is an empty set, again power set of the power set of an empty set, this cardinality here, it is going to be 2. The cardinality is 2. If you see the power set of the power set of the power set of a set which is containing 0 elements, or you can say cardinality of the set A is 0, that means A is not containing any element. So if you take power set here 3 times, so number of elements, again it is going to be increased. So tell me, what will the cardinality of this one? If you take power set of the power set of the power set of the set A, which is an empty set, what will the cardinality in this case? Equal sets are 2 sets which are having same values. Power set is a set of subsets. It is not going to be 3, Tavleen. Yes, it is going to be 4, because A is having cardinality as 0. Power set of A is having cardinality of 1. Power set of A is having cardinality of 2. Power set of A is having cardinality of 4. So it is having 0. This will be having 2 raised to power 0. This will be having 2 raised to power 0. This will be having 2 raised to power 0, and so on. Is it clear, my dear friends? I hope you guys understood it properly. You guys are very smart, super intelligent, extraordinary people. Chalo. So next is your ordered tuple and Cartesian product. Ordered tuple and Cartesian product. So basically, if you take a Cartesian product, so first of all, let us explain what is the ordered tuple. Ordered tuple means if you have some elements, then the order of the element matters. For example, if we say we have 1, comma, if we have the elements 1, comma, 2, comma, Himanshu. So this is not equal to 2, comma, 1, comma, Himanshu. It is not equal to this, because if we take ordered set or ordered tuple, that means here the order of the elements matter. And remember, here I'm not talking about ordered set, here I'm talking about ordered tuple. So there are two things. One is ordered set, and second is ordered tuple. Okay, so basically ordered tuple means, here in this tuple the order of the element matters. For example, 1, 2 is not equal to 2, 1. So if the order of the element matters here, so that becomes ordered tuple. Now if you talk about the ordered set, for example here, Cartesian product contains ordered pairs. Okay, let me explain you what do you mean by ordered pair. Let us suppose we have a set A. It is having the values which is 1, 2. We have a set B. We have a set B which is having the values small a, small b. If you took A cross B, so A cross B will be containing ordered tuples, okay, which is 1, a, 1, b, 2, a, and 2, b. If you do B cross A, so B cross A will be, what will be? A, 1, A, 2, B, 1, and B, 2. So here you can clearly see A cross B is not equal to B cross A. So A cross B is not equal to B cross A. Therefore, you can say Cartesian product of two sets, it is not commutative unless both these sets are having same values or both the sets are equal. Okay, so you can see Cartesian product is not commutative. Cartesian product is not commutative. So commutative means if we say A cross B is equal to B cross A, that means it becomes commutative. So here in case of Cartesian product, A cross B is not equal to B cross A. Therefore you can say Cartesian product is not commutative. The reason is 1, a is not equal to a, 1, because this is representing an ordered tuple. 1, a is not equal to a, 1. So all the elements here in A cross B, they are different as compared to all the elements which are containing in B cross A. So this set containing different elements, and this set is also containing different elements. Okay, is it clear? Any doubts, my dear friends? So in case of Cartesian product, if the cardinality of the first set, for example here the cardinality of set A is 2, and if the cardinality of the second set here B is also 2, therefore the cardinality of their cross product is going to be 2 cross 2, which is equal to 4. Or roughly if I say, if the cardinality of the first set A is m, the cardinality of the second set B is n, then the cardinality of A cross B is going to be m cross n. Cardinality of A cross B will be m cross n. Okay, I hope this much is clear to everyone. Aap sabhi ko ye point clear hoga. You can understand it properly. You are super, super intelligent people. So this is just an example of Cartesian product. So as we have already seen, if the set A is one having elements 1, 2, the set B is having the elements a, b, c. So A cross B is having, this is having 2 elements, this is having 3 elements. So this set is having total 6 elements. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are total of 6 elements. And here B cross A is also having 6 elements. But here you can see the order of these elements matters. So 1, a is not equal to a, 1. So B cross A is different and A cross B is different. So you can clearly see the Cartesian product is not commutative. Okay. So they will be equal. A cross B and B cross A are Cartesian product of A cross B and B cross A are not equal unless A is phi or B is phi. If A is phi and B is phi, or you can say if A and B are also having same elements, then only they will be equal. Okay, so we can extend it to furthermore. We can even have Cartesian product of more than two sets. So here we have Cartesian product of three sets, set A cross set B cross set C. Set A is having 2 elements, set B is having 2 elements, set C is having 2 elements. So here you can see the Cartesian product, you can find it out and you can clearly write the Cartesian product. Okay, and remember here, the Cartesian product is not commutative, but the Cartesian product is associative. Right? I'm saying Cartesian product is not commutative, but Cartesian product is associative. Cartesian product is associative. Associative means if you have A cross B cross C, so you can give precedence to anything. You can first multiply A cross B and then you can multiply the result with C. I try to find new things to make the class interesting sometimes. Jokes, I don't know jokes. Jokes to aate nahi hai. But anyways, so here A is 1, 2. A square is, when I write A square is A cross A. If I write A cube is A cross A. Okay? Now this is an important part. The part is relations. So this part is relations. First read this paragraph. So basically what are relations? This part will be our next, once I finish the PPTs for sets, then we'll be discussing about the topic of relations. So basically what are relations? Relations are the subset of Cartesian product of a set. So generally you define how two elements are related to each other in a relation. For example, if I say we can have a set A which is having the values 1, 2, 3. So Cartesian product of A cross A, which will be having the elements 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 3, 2, and 3, 3. This is A cross A. Now we can also have a Cartesian product with another set. I can say we can have a set B which is having the values 4 and 5. So I can also find A cross B. But anyways, I can also define a relation on this. I can say we have a relation R1 which is having the ordered pair from here, which is X and Y, such that Y divides X. So basically I'm defining some kind of property. So for example, here you can say this one divides 1. So in this relation we can have 1, 1. Again 2 does not divide 1, 3 does not divide 1, but 1 divides 2. So here we can have 2, 1. 2 divides 2, so here we can have 2, 2. 1 divides 3, so here we can have 3, 1. 3 divides 3, so here we can have 3, 3. So this is a relation. So basically when we say relation, a relation is always a subset of the Cartesian product. And secondly, in a relation, the elements satisfy some conditions. We have to tell what are the conditions that the elements have to satisfy. So then we can define what are relations. So relations will be coming later on after this. So I just wanted to give a short, brief introduction to relations. But again, we'll be studying relations in more details in the upcoming PPTs. Okay. Is it clear? If you still do not understand relations, don't worry, because we are going to study relations in more details. Relations ko hum aur kafi zyada details ke andar study karenge. Agar aapko relations samajh mein nahi aaya abhi bhi, don't worry about it whatsoever. Don't worry. Okay? You can read this paragraph later on according to your wish. So this is just for your understanding. Now look at these questions. Determine which of these statements are true, which of these statements are false. So for this, everyone, for this first question from here to here, A to G, tell me what are the statements which are true, what are the statements which are false. Jaldi se comment kar dijiye, please comment on the chat window from for this first question. Tell me what of these statements are true and how many of these statements are false. Okay, so let's check. So first one, 0 belongs to 5. This is false. Second, 5 belongs to 0. Is it true? The second one, 5 belongs to 0. Yes, this is false. It is not correct. The reason is, if you see the set on the right hand side, it is having only one element, which is 0. Okay, so 5 does not belong to this. It is not true. So those who have written true, they are wrong. Mary, Smita, Darpan, Sakshi, Pranita, all of you are wrong, because this statement is false. If this set could have been like this, that it is having 5, 0, then I could have said that 5 belongs to this set. But here on the right hand side, this set is only having one element, which is 0. So 5 does not belong to this set. Okay, correct. Now look at this one. Is this set of subset of that? See, here it means this is actually equivalent to saying like this. So now that means this set is containing two elements, which is 5 and 0. We are not saying 5 as a subset. We are not saying 5 is a subset of 0. We are not saying this statement. This statement is different and this statement is different. This is saying whether this element 5 belong to this set or not. Okay? This is belongs to symbol. This is proper subset symbol. And this is subset symbol. So you should not confuse between belongs to symbol, proper subset and subset. In teeno cheezo mein confuse nahi hona hai. Right? So here you can see 5 is an empty set. Here in the option number A, it is saying 0 belongs to this empty set. But this empty set does not contain any element. So 0 cannot belong to this. So the first statement is also false. What about the third statement? What about the third statement now? So you can see here they are asking about proper set and this is an empty set. An empty set has no proper subset. An empty set has no proper subset. So you can write it down. An empty set has no proper subset. Write it down. Look at the next one. D is 5 is a proper subset of 0. So this statement is true. This statement is true. Here you can see 5 belongs to a set which is having element 0. This is false. And 5 is a proper subset of this set which is having element 0. That is true. Okay. Now look at this statement. E. E is true or false? I need answers from all of you. E is true or false? Sakshi, I think I answered your doubts. Please let me know if you still have doubt on that option number B. Check out about the option number E, whether E is true or false. So option number E is false. Why option number E is false? Option number E is false. Why? Because here this is belongs to. It is not proper subset or it is not subset. Belongs to means whether this element is containing in this set or not. So you can say, if I say we have 0 belongs to this set. Right? So you can say this set belongs to this set because this set is containing this set. Okay. For example, if I say we have a set A, which is having the elements 1, 2, 3. I can say 1 belongs to the set A. I can say 2 belongs to the set A. I can say 3 belongs to the set A. So belongs to word is different. Belongs to is different and subset is different and proper subset is different. Okay, so you can say E is also false. Karima, your comment is not clear. You are commenting about which option? What about F? Whether F is true or false? A is false, B is false, C is also false, D is true, E is false, F is true or false? Actually, F is false, and G here is true. G is true and F is false. Any doubts in them? Any doubts whatsoever? Okay, now check out this one. Tell me which of the following is true and which of the following is false. Isme se kaun sa true hai aur kaun sa false hai? For the next question, G is true because we are talking about subset. This is not belongs to symbol. Basically, you guys are confusing between belongs to symbol and subset symbol, right? So these are two different symbols. This is saying whether this is an element of this set. This is saying whether this set is a subset of this set. So both of them are two different options. Okay, do you still need the explanation for G? For the second question, write answers. So in E, see this E jo hai, E ke case mein, अगर मैं E की बात करता हूँ तो अगर ये सेट कुछ ऐसा होता कि 0 belongs to 0,0. So here you can see this proper is a subset here. But this proper is an element of this set. So belongs to means we are checking whether this is an element of this set. So here you can see this complete is not an element of this set. Only 0 is the element of this set. Right? So this complete is not an element of this set. Fine. So here you can see 0 belongs to this set, it is correct. If I say this belongs to this, it is wrong. Okay. Now check out what the second question and write the answers of the second question. Ashi, G is true because we are talking about subset. Right? This is not a belongs to symbol, this is a subset symbol. This is a belongs to symbol. Both of them are true different symbols. So here in this case, this first statement is true. This second statement is also true because this phi is here. This third statement here is false. Okay, so because this question was exactly, I think this question is similar to this. So this is false. Here you can see D is true. If you see E, E is also true. Okay. And if you see F, F is also true. Because this set is containing two elements. One of this element is phi. This set is also containing two elements. One of this element is this set containing phi. If you go check out G, G is false because this is same elements, so this is not a proper subset, right? This is not a proper subset, this is just a subset, not a proper subset. So correct answer is true, true, false, true, true, false. So true, true, false, true, false, correct. Pallavi, all your answers are correct. Any other answers from anyone? Please ask me if you have any doubts with this. So C and G, both of them are false. Please ask me if you have any doubts with this. Proper subset means both of them should not be equal. So here you can see in this set, in this direction, you can see this set is not containing two elements. Because a set cannot contain duplicate elements. For example, if we have a set A which is having the elements 1, 1. So 1, 1 is not allowed because this should be actually equivalent to a set A which is having only one element, which is 1. A set cannot have duplicate elements, but here this set is containing duplicate elements. So because this set is containing duplicate elements, so only one of these elements will be counted. These elements will not be counted as 2. And secondly, when we say a proper subset should not be same. Proper subsets should not contain exactly the same value. So this set is only having one value, which is a set containing 5. And this set is also having only one value, which is a set containing 5. Okay. Any doubts? Clear? You guys are super smart, intelligent. Let me give you more questions then. आपको मैं और अच्छे अच्छे questions देता हूँ ताकि आप मेरे इन सवालों का जवाब दें, हमारी आज की कक्षा सफल हो जाए, we become happy. Okay, you still need the explanation. So you are asking about how f is true. See, on the right hand side we have a set which is containing 2 element. So this is a set which is containing the first element as 5 and second element as a set which is containing 5. Okay, so remember what I am saying. We have a set A, it contains 5, 1, 2 and 1, 2. So you can count how many elements are there in the set A. How many elements are in the set A? In the set A, the first element is a set, which is a first element is an empty set, second element is 1, third element is 2, and the fourth element is a set which is containing 2 elements. So it is a set which is containing a set. If I say we have a set B which is containing 5, so basically this is equivalent to saying double brackets like this. It means it is a set which is containing an empty set. A set which is containing an empty set. Now if you see this set, in this set we have 2 elements. The first element is an empty set. The second element is a set which is containing an empty set. So these are 2 different elements. And here on the left hand side we have only one element, which is a set containing an empty set. So this element is present here. This element is present here. So you can clearly see this left hand side is a proper subset of this right hand side. Okay, clear? Now do you need any explanation for G? Please clear. If it is clear, I can move on to the next question. If it is clear, so in G you can see that both these elements are same, but the problem here in G is that they are asking about the proper subset. So because they are asking about the proper subset, therefore it is wrong. This is false. If instead of proper subset, if they could have asked about a subset, so subset is different and proper subset is different. If the symbol could have been a subset, then this is true. Now this statement is true. But because they are asking about a proper subset, that is why this statement is false. Clear? Do you still have doubts? Please let me know. If you still have doubts, please ask me. So the answer here is true, false. Check out and confirm your answers. How many of you are true? How many of you are correct? So A is true. B is also true. B is also true. Darpan, your answer B is wrong. Tavleen, your answer for B is also wrong. Vijay, your answer, some of your answers are wrong. None of you have given, Harika gave all the correct answers. So only C and F are false. So do you have any doubts in any one of them? think your first answer was B, false. Chalo, no problem. So do any one of you have any doubts in the first question? E, you need the explanation for E. See, Dev, in case of E, this is an empty set. An empty set is also a subset of any set. Empty set will be a subset here. Okay? So X, this is a set which is having one element, and this is an empty set. So this, if this question is phi belongs to the set X, then it will be false. But here they are asking empty set is a subset of X, that is true. Okay? Madhuri, last question, last one, F is wrong. F is false. Okay? Now check out the second question. If you have doubt for the first question, please ask. And if you do not have the doubt for the first question, please write the answers in this of the second question. Please write answer in one line instead of making separate comment for every option, because that is basically difficult for me to understand. Please write the answer in one line for the second question. So which of the following set determine whether 2 is an element of that set? So in the first set, X belongs to R, where R is representing what? R is a set of what? Where X is an integer greater than 1. X belongs to R, where X is square of an integer. And in how many of these sets 2 will be an element? So here you can see 2 is not an element. 2 is not an element of this set. And here also 2 is not an element of this set. In C, 2 is an element. So D, E and F, all of them are false. So D, E and F, they are false. Tavleen, C is true. So check out the next question. They're asking what is the cardinality of each of these sets? What is the cardinality? So cardinality of the first option is 1. Here the cardinality is 1. Here the cardinality is also 1, because this is a set containing another set. Here the cardinality is 2. Here the cardinality is 3. This is first element, second element, this is the third element. So this is the cardinality is 3. Okay. Then what is the cardinality of each of these sets? So the first set, the cardinality here is 0. The cardinality here is 1. The cardinality here is 2. The cardinality here is 3. Find the power set of each of these sets where B, A and B are distinct elements. So here the power set will be containing 2 elements. Here the power set will be containing 4 elements. Here the power set will be containing 4 elements. Maybe I'll just check and I'll tell you the answer, don't worry, in some time, okay? Yes, I will explain the previous question. Previous question, Dev, don't worry. So here you can see, if you see this question, they're asking 2 is an element of which of the following? So let us see the option number C, D and F first, then we'll come back to option number A and B. So in option number C, 2 belongs to this set, 2 is present here, right? So 2 is an element here. In this set, 2 is not an element, because this set is containing 2 elements. The first one is a set containing 2. The second one is a set containing another set which is containing 2. So here 2 is not an element. If they could have written something like this, 2 comma this set which is containing 2, this set which is containing another set which is containing 2. So here now if they ask whether 2 is belongs to this set or not, then you will say yes, 2 belongs to the set. But here you can see 2 does not 2 belongs to the set, and here 2 does not belong to this set. Okay. Now you can clearly see here, again, this is the first element which is a set containing 2. The second element which is a set containing 2 elements. The first one element is 2, a second element is a set containing 2. So here 2 does not belongs to this. 2 does not belongs to this. Okay. So in this case of D, if they could have written whether this 2 belongs to the set, yes, this 2 belongs to the set. Okay. Now in this option number F, it is a set containing another set, which is containing 2. So here again, 2 does not belong to this set. So these things should be clear first of all. Now after this, you check out the option number A and B. Now in case of option number A, they are saying X belongs to R. Now first of all, tell me, what do you mean by R? What is R? R is a set of rational number, R is a set of real numbers. What is R? Tell me, what do you mean by R? So R, basically R is a set of real numbers, right? Here R is a set of real numbers. So they are saying X belongs to the set of real number. X is an integer greater than 1. So how many integers are there which are greater than 1? That is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on. So here you can see 2 belongs to this set. 2 is an element of this set. In the second case, they are saying X is a real number where X is the square of an integer. So square of 1 is 1, square of 2 is 4, square of 3 is 9, square of 4 is 16 and so on. So in this case, in option number B, it does not contain 2 because it contains the square of the integers. Okay, so in option number B, 2 cannot be there, 2 is not an element. In option number A, 2 is an element. Is it clear? Yes, A is true, B is false, C is true, D, E and F are false. Okay. So check out this question. I think I've already given you the solution of this question. Then check out this question. So they're asking, how many elements does each of these sets have where A and B are distinct elements? So how many elements? This is a power set, this is representing power set, this is representing power set. So they're asking, how many elements does each of these set contain? Devendra, after this page, I'll give you a break. You can take a break, by the way. You can view just this question after the break. I'll give a break after this. So you can take a break now, but I'll cover these questions, these two questions, okay? Okay, you can do this question by yourself, the second part. The first part you can see, in this case they are asking, this is a set, then what is the power set of this set? So this containing set is containing three elements, which is A, B, and the third element is a set. So this is a set which is containing three elements, and they are asking for this set, what will be the power set? So power set will be having 2 raised to power 3 elements, which I already told you, power set of a set. For example, if I say set A is having cardinality as n, then power set of A will be having a cardinality of 2 raised to power n. Now here you can see, this is a set which is containing cardinality as 3. It is containing 3 elements. So its power set will be containing 2 raised to power 3 elements, which is 8. So in the second case, this is a set which is containing 4 elements. This is the first element, which is 5. The second element is A. The third element is a set containing A. The fourth element is a set containing A, right? So this set is having 4 elements, and the power set will be having 2 raised to power 4 elements, which is 16. In the third case, we have a set which is containing 5, and then power set of 5 will be having, you can see how many elements, and again you can have again a power set of that. Okay, so this is how you can solve these questions. I hope this much is clear. So phi is a set containing 0 element, power set of phi is a set containing 1 element, the power set of phi is a set which is containing 2 elements. I have already explained this portion to you. Okay. Good, if it is clear. Now you can take a break, this question you can do by yourself. After the break, we'll start with some of the operations like union, intersection. We'll start all, with all these operations after the break. Okay, so the break is for half an hour, we will start at 9:30. I want to finish at least this topic, sets, by today itself. We'll start at 9:30. If we finish sets today, then tomorrow we can complete relations. Okay, so tomorrow we'll have a we'll have earlier class, because today I had a class at so today I was late because 7:30 we started. Tomorrow we'll start early. Okay, so we have to finish sets today. So take a break. After the break, we will meet.